Indianapolis Colts have got some problems, my brother. They have big-time problems. It wasn't just that Carson Wentz went out with a foot injury, and they came out right after we did our show on Monday morning when we were talking about they don't know what the severity is. They don't know how long he's going to be out. So they gave us some kind of a timetable. They said,
fine. Hang on now. Hang on. I love how they didn't know what was wrong with him, but they did surgery.
Right. Right.
Like, hang on. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. You mean to tell me your doctors went in and cut on him, but they didn't know what they were going to go do? No, no, no. That tells me they always know. They just don't want to say it because it's probably really bad.
Yes. Yes. So they told us a guesstimated timetable.
5 to 12 weeks. Sometime in the next, I don't know, calendar year, he might play again. He
might be back. Maybe. I mean, it's so absurd.
This is like when you call Comcast to come fix your shit at your house, Gary, and they say, we'll be there sometime Tuesday, and you'd be like, can you give me a time? Be like, yeah, between 8 and 8.
Between Tuesday and the next Tuesday, basically.
Yeah. It's like, yeah. We didn't say what Tuesday. Doing? We just said we'll be there Tuesday, and you just sit the hell down and wait on me.
Matt said that happens way more than you think. Yeah, I could believe it. He said foot injuries take a long time to recover. So why are you even telling us 5 weeks? Because I don't know that it's going to be 5 weeks. Like Matt Miller said, at least one good team each year is wiped out by injuries. It looks like the Colts are that team this year. I mean, the Colts have had to deal with some injuries in the past, but it was the Eagles when Carson Wentz was there, and now he moves over to Indianapolis. So the other big news is Quenton Nelson, the number one rated guard, out. Yeah.
And this guy's a monster. I think this is one of the best offensive linemen in the game, if not the best offensive lineman.
He was definitely, PFF rated him as the number one guard.
The number one guard, yep. No, but I mean, I know guards don't get the pub that the tackles get. I don't know if there are any tackles out there that are more important to their team than he is to this team.
Oh, I tend to agree.
Or as good at what they do as he's good at what he does.
And then, of course, Ryan Kelly, the center, hyperextended his elbow. He's out for 2 weeks.
Now, hang on. What was the Quenton Nelson time frame, though? I didn't get that.
It's the exact same as Carson Wentz. It's the same injury. 5 to 12 weeks is what they
say. So bad. So listen now. Feet problems for a quarterback that needs to stop running, not the end of the world. Feet problems for a big, massive guard, that, like, he could never be the same again if they can't fix it right.
Yeah. No,
that would be a situation where if this thing looks like it's going south like Sherman, then this team needs to just set Quenton down for the year and say, Mr. Nelson, just rest that foot and please be better for next year.
So, read an interesting article, Pro Football Rumors posted it, said that the Colts are not interested in making a trade even though they don't know how long Wentz is going to be out. I think that changes, or that changed to this because of the Nelson injury. Like, do you feel like that's it? Like, Darius Leonard is out right now. Ryan Kelly's out right now. Like, you know.
If it seems like everything's going south, then let's not give up a bunch of assets to try to Band-Aid a bad situation because a Band-Aid's not fixing this, all right? I was kind of hating that these other injuries happen for the same reason that not for the same reason, but for the reason that the guy that a lot of people thought they might bring in and would be available, who's really cheap right now, would be Nick Foles.
Yeah, that's the names that are listed on here. Chris Mortensen reported that they won't be making a trade for the likes of Nick Foles, Gardner Minshew, or Marcus Mariota.
They were going to consider them, and then everybody else started falling apart. And now it's a situation where it's, let's just sit back and see how this plays out.
Yeah.
Because I do think this team is a quarterback away from being a really good football team if all these other pieces are there.
I agree.
Without those pieces, that's going to be tough. I just thought it would be really funny that Carson would lose his job once again to a guy that's not very good at quarterback position anywhere else. But whenever he takes Carson's job, he's really good.
Hey, Matt Miller jumped in and said Ellinger's going to beat out Eason, by the way. Said Eason has more talent, but Ellinger is going to fit Reich's offense better.
I wouldn't hate that. I kind of hope that happens because I like Sam Ellinger. I have no idea why. I never enjoyed Texas. I think Texas fans were such assholes to me. But now that Sam's not there anymore, like I kind of want to see him do well.
That makes sense.
Yeah. I'd like to see it.
I'd like to see it too. I mean, you never know. McKinnon jumps in, said, howdy, gents. He said, my question is, who the hell is interested in trading for Wentz now? Nobody. This would not be a trade Wentz for a different quarterback. This would be trade some other asset, picks or something. Matt Miller said, didn't the Raiders want a first for Mariota at some point last year, which is asinine?
Now, that was last year. This year, yeah. I think they'd take a third and they'd run for the hills.
Yeah. Yeah.
But I might be wrong.
Either way, they got injury issues. They're not looking to make trades. They are trying to figure this out.
I do think that's smart, by the way. Yeah. I do think that is, if everything's falling around you, there's no use in Warwich in the future if it looks like chaos is happening, right?
Well, and didn't, like, so on top of those injuries, didn't I just read something about Frank Reich, it tested positive for COVID, so he's out for 2 weeks?
But that doesn't,
that's not an injury.
As long as he stays out of the hospital, I'm not worried about a coach getting COVID, okay?
Well, agreed.
If he goes in the hospital for it.
I'm just talking about he is not on site to go through these practices and as we're getting ready for the preseason stuff. Just talking about chaos all around. It will just toss that one on top of the fire, right?
Yeah, sure. I'm too worried about that.
Doesn't affect a whole lot.
Right now, they got a lot of other problems. I'll tell you this. Losing Carson Wentz ain't the biggest problem you got. Losing Quenton Nelson, the biggest problem in the league right now.
So, and with that said, we've talked about BetUS.com. All of the odds for the AFC South teams are off the board. All of the win totals, everything. And it's not just the Colts. It is everybody. The Texans, they took that off the board because they don't know what's happening with Deshaun Watson. They also took the Titans and the Jags off because if we can't figure out what's going on with all these injuries with the Colts and what's going to happen with the Texans quarterback situation, everything goes up in smoke at that point.
You definitely can't have good odds to win the division or good team total odds because they play each other so much. It's such a – if you said there are four games – of the Texans, of the Titans or the Jaguars that we got to block out and we can't really account any information on because we don't really know what's going on with it, you can't put an accurate team total up there, and you definitely can't put an accurate price to win the division. And if you're going to price it, you just price it really bad. You just make it to where nobody has good odds to win.
Yeah, nobody wants to bet it. So
yeah,
that would make sense. Let's keep going. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com, and if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter, at GaryWCE, at ChrisBGiannini, at WinningCures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com, or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.